Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, we will cover how to create a custom report in Insight. We'll begin by looking at what Insight is and the types of users. Then we'll jump into Insight and I'll walk you through the steps to create a custom report. Modern marketing is fueled by intelligent data analysis and reporting. Insight features a complete set of out-of-the-box reports that can help your entire marketing organization analyze data and make critical decisions. Together with Eloqua's dashboards, Eloqua gives you the analytics tools you need to meet your marketing goals. Let's have a look at the different types of Insight users. All Eloqua customers have access to Insight reporting, where you can run standard reports and use standard functions. But some organizations or users will need more functionality to modify existing reports or create their own custom reports. To do so, you'll need an analyzer license. Depending on the product subscription level you've purchased, you may already have an analyzer license, but you can always purchase one as an add-on. In this video, I will show you how to create a custom report, provided you have an analyzer license. On the My Eloqua dashboard, navigate to Analytics, then click Insight. This will bring you to the new Insight homepage, which you can see is powered by Oracle Business Intelligence. If you're an analyzer, you will see this new menu. For this video, I will be starting with an existing report. However, you can create a custom report by clicking Analysis. We're going to customize the Email Analysis Overview report. To begin, click Edit to open the Analysis Editor. This is what we'll use to customize the report. If you were creating a custom report from scratch, you would also be working in the Analysis Editor. Here, we can see the columns already in the report and any existing filters. The Subject Area panel contains attribute and metric columns that represent Eloqua's data. We've made several subject areas for you, and typically, when you build a report, you should be able to find the data you're looking for within one subject area. So, let's start by adding some columns to our report. To add columns, simply drag and drop them. You can also delete columns by hovering over one and selecting Delete. You can sort the columns to make the report easier to read. We will sort our report first by email name, then by total sends. Click Options next to email name, then sort ascending. This icon should appear. Next to total sends, click Options, then Sort, then add descending sort. To preview the report, click the Results tab. Here, you can add a title, reorder columns, and change other display properties. Keep in mind that the Results tab shows all data and will not apply any prompts yet. We will come back to this tab later. You can also filter to limit the results that are included in the report. We'll filter ours so that it only includes emails that were actually sent. To do this, return to the Criteria tab. Here, click Filter, then Total Sends. Select is greater than or equal to, then type 1 in the value field. Click OK. You can switch between the and or options by clicking on it. Going back to the Results tab, we will now change the way our report displays. Our report includes two views, a title view which shows the report name, and a table view which shows the results. You can do a number of things here, such as remove columns or add calculations, but we will add a title to our report and limit the number of rows that the report displays. In the title view, click Edit View and type in a title. Deselect the Display Save Name checkbox. Leaving this selected will make the title we use to save the report also appear. There are other customizable fields here. When you're finished, click Done. Now we'll limit the number of rows. In the Table view, click View Properties. Set the following properties like so. Click OK. Our next step is to add a new prompt to our report, which will allow users to select values and dynamically filter the report. Start by clicking the Prompts tab. Click New, then Column Prompt, then More Columns. From here, expand Attributes, then Contact. Select Contact Country. Here, we've allowed users to select multiple values and to type values. Click OK. The new prompt will appear in the display area. When a reporter opens the report, they will be asked to specify the context country. The last step is to save our report. To do this, click Save. You can either save it to a private folder so it's only visible to you, or a shared folder so that it's visible to all your organization's report users. Let's put ours in a new folder so that we can share it with our reporters. Give your report a name, then click OK. And there you have it, a newly customized report. Your final report should look like this. That concludes this video on creating a custom report in Insight. For more information, check out our other videos about working in Insight, or go to Topliners and click Know It. Thank you for watching!